Hello, boys and girls. My name is Miss Stephanie, and I'm back with another interesting book to read today. I hope you enjoyed this one. It's called Jackrabbit McCabe and the Electric Telegraph. So we're going to find out. He has got long legs. Do you notice that? We're going to find out about him. Everyone likes to run, I'm sure. And boy, does he like to run, and he can run fast. And we're going to find out how that happened. And this is kind of a legend, sort of like a Paul Bunyan legend, if you've ever heard of him. Kind of a tall tale, so let's get started. This here's the story of Jackrabbit McCabe, who was born to run. At birth, his legs were so long, they looped like a pretzel, and his father had to add an extra axle to the baby carriage. See how long it is? Some long legs. When he was a three-year-old, his mama dressed him in long pants every morning. And do you notice they're getting shorter? By noon, his sock tops were showing, and by 5 o'clock, he was wearing shorts. That's how fast he was growing. Little Jack chased whatever would run, hogs, dogs, even his own shadow. That must have been fun. Have you ever tried to outrun your shadow? As he got older, he raced his trains. He raced trains flying past his house in Windy Flats. For years, the engineers cheered him on. By the time he turned 18, he'd beat every stagecoach, antelope, and locomotive in the territory. He outran a train. That's fast. Perched on the edge of the Great Plains, the town of Windy Flats always counted on Jackrabbit's speed when a message had to get out fast, like to fetch old Doc Dobbins to patch up some ninny from the Double Dare Ya Club who fell while climbing up St. Bertha's church steeple. He went up a little too high, I would say, and came down a little hard. Whenever the sky turned green and the twisters bore down, Jackrabbit rounded up every wandering chick and child and plunked them safe back home. On Sunday afternoons, he ran in horse races at the county fairgrounds. Folks who knew Jackrabbit always bet on him to place first. Since he earned a piece of the pot, he made good money. Then one day, something new came to Windy Flats, the electric telegraph. Out east, telegraph wires were already crisscrossing the landscape, carrying messages quicker than the mail by using electricity. Every city and town connected by the wires had a telegraph and an operator who sent and received messages in Morse code, an alphabet of dots and dashes. You may have heard of Morse code. The first week, the telegraph company showed up in Windy Flats. There was plenty of talk. I don't believe any newfangled contraption can carry a message faster than Jackrabbit, said Mayor Babel. Nor do I, said Judge Festoon. The telegraph man overheard their boast and said, how about a race between your fella and this here electric telegraph? Sandy Bluff just got themselves an operator that's pert near 25 miles as the crow flies. Of course, the mayor had no trouble convincing Jackrabbit to race. Why, yes, sir, Jackrabbit said, I can outrun anything. On the day of the big showdown, folks came from miles around. Windy Flats felt as festive as a flag-waving jubilee. A brass band played, and Mayor Babel spoke. Then the mayor carefully wrote down the same message on two slips of paper. He handed one to the telegraph man and the other to Jackrabbit. To start the race, Judge Festoon hollered so everyone could hear, "On your marks! Get set!" A finger hovered just above the telegraph key. Jackrabbit leaned way over with one foot already in the air. Who do you think is going to win? Jackrabbit or the man typing on the telegraph? Go! Down went the telegraph key. Off shot Jackrabbit McCabe. Jackrabbit pumped his legs, kicking up storm clouds of dust. On the flat roof of the mercantile, children whooped and hollered as they watched him roar like a tornado down the road and out of sight. The crowd held its breath. In a few moments, a reply came chattering back as that telegraph key jumped and smacked all on its own. The telegraph man quickly read the code and shouted, "Message received, stop. Sandy Bluff operator." The crowd let its breath go in one great sigh. "Oh, shucks. Where's Jackrabbit McCabe?" they ask each other. Well, sir, Jackrabbit ran in record time, 9.5 minutes to Sandy Bluff, but there was no brass band to welcome him. Only a telegram tacked up on the door of the depot. It read, "As that fine statesman and inventor Benjamin Franklin once said, energy and persistence conquer all things. Stop. Mayor Babble of Windy Flats." Jackrabbit pulled the mayor's message out of his pocket and read it to the Sandy Bluff telegraph operator. "Yep, they're the same. I guess I got beat." Jackrabbit felt lower than a snake's navel. He took a slow stagecoach ride home. First time he ever lost a race. Meanwhile, Mayor Babble paced and thought. He was barely listening to the telegraph man's talk until he heard, "Say, who's going to be your telegraph operator?" Suddenly the mayor perked up. "Well, what about Jackrabbit McCabe?" he said. "If his fingers are half as speedy as his long legs, we're in business." And so when Jackrabbit finally arrived back in Windy Flats, Mayor Babble was there to greet him. "Good news, my friend. How would you like to become the first telegraph operator of our fair city?" Jackrabbit's shy grin quickly grew into a face-splitting smile. He jumped up with a big wahoo and ran 6 times around the town. So Jackrabbit sent away for a Morse code book, and when it came, he practiced every minute. Before long, his fingers flew like a banjo player's, strumming that telegraph key. Day in and day out, he sent and received messages, and of course, hand-delivered telegrams in a flash. He even teamed up with a local typesetter who printed the news that came over that wire, linking Windy Flats to the whole entire country. And who do you think delivered the newspaper every evening? That's right, Jackrabbit, who would run through every speck of town as fast as a squirrel hightails it up a tree. And what's more, he could land a paper at every door. Now I ask you, was there ever any fellow so all-fired expeditious as Jackrabbit McCabe? Expeditious means, have you ever heard of anyone as fast as Jackrabbit? The end. Stop. That's when, in telegraph talk, when they had that, that means that was the end of what you were saying. They would say, stop. So I hope you liked that book. That's a lot to try to follow with someone who could run that fast. I don't think I could run and beat him in a race, but maybe you could. So I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time.